voice is an instrument, so I got to tune up too.
Muy buenas noches. Muy buenas noches. Come on, the snoring hasn't started yet. Already? It's my absolute pleasure to be here with you this evening with our CSUSB orchestra for a night of Hispanic classical and folk music. From what I've been told, I just got the program, is tonight's spread of music includes works by composers from Mexico, Spain, Argentina, Paraguay, and Peru. So the program will feature works by composers Arturo Marquez, Silvestre Revueltas, José Pablo Moncayo, Héctor Villalobos, Astor Piazzolla, Isaac Albeniz, and will also feature our CSUSB Young Artist Competition winner, Ricardo Arriaga, playing the, there you go, let's hear it up. Let's hear it up for Ricardo. What is that instrument that you're holding? What is that called?
A bassoon.
Órale. Muy bien. All right. He's going to be playing the first movement of Ney Rosado's Concerto Number 1 for Marimba and String Orchestra. I'm Enrique Murillo. I'm a professor here on campus, director of LEAD, Latino Education Advocacy Days. I've been here for 20 years, and this for me, this is an absolute pleasure. I'm grateful to Dr. Lucy Lewis, Assistant Professor of Orchestral Music Education, who reached out to me. Where's Lucy? Let's give her a round of applause. Where was she at? And her eyes are stunning. I was talking to her, and I was just like staring at her eyes. I was like, oh, my God, mesmerizing. Immediately, when she reached out to me, this whole night harkened back to a good memory I had when in 2015, the LEAD projects, the ones I direct, collaborated with the San Bernardino Symphony, and through the support of the James Irvine Foundation, their foundation's Exploring Engagement Grant Initiative, we put on a Mosaico Festival, which was a dynamic concert held on our campus celebrating diverse and beautiful music of Latin American origin. Leading up to the festival, I had the pleasure of conducting a series of community conversations. So we're sitting there with Raza, working class folks, asking them, hey, tell us about your experiences with classical music. And there was a lot of mixed histories. Some people had been exposed to it, some people had not. And so the purpose of the conversations was to gain insights into the roles music has played in the lives of persons from diverse Latino cultures. Of course, being Latino, being Mexican, music, it means get up, and it's Saturday morning, Sunday morning means get up, do the laundry, clean the kitchen, mop the floors, clean up your room, you know. So the music plays a role in our lives like that. There are many barriers that exist for us, especially growing up Latino in the United States. But access to classical music is one of those subjects we really don't talk about too often. But it really is a barrier, if you think about it. There seems to be a very low percentage of Latinos who in surveys admit that they like or enjoy classical or instrumental music. Right? So we have to change that, right? So part of the projects is that we have to change that. Some people say, oh, it's boring. Some people say, oh, it's this and that. They think of it as like highbrow, right, like in the class system. So we have to really push ourselves to break down those barriers. Why? Because we think classical music is it's the heritage of all of us. It belongs to all of us, right, not to just a certain group of people. And so for the classical musical world, this is the question. Where are the audiences of the future, right? Where are the audiences of the future? Well, we have to create them. Tonight, we're creating future audiences. Thank you for any of you who brought children, or if this is your first time, congratulations. Because like I said, this belongs to all of us. There's a rich history in Latin America. that most people don't know in terms of the of orchestral and classical music. A lot of the famous musicians, you know, the música ranchera were classically trained, right? A lot of people just don't know, you know, don't know that. So tonight we're gonna be creating future audiences. That's what we're doing. We have to build awareness, share insights, foment reciprocal and horizontal relationships among our area's diverse and underserved communities. So again, thank you for allowing me to be here. Your presence affirms that the culture of music transcends ethnicity. So why not foster that idea and engage more people and have more nights like this? So again, thank you. I invite you to our LEAD Summit, a Latino Education Advocacy Day Summit, which takes place Thursday, March 28th here on our campus. And I left flyers outside the door, so please help yourself. Okay, muy buenas noches y que disfruten. All right. Thank you.
harp in Paraguay happens to be their national instrument. And this young man here plays it very well. We're going to do something called Pájaro Campana. It's a bird generally based in Paraguay chorus. And it makes a sound. You'll get it. We're going to play around with it. And we're going to play around also with the syncopation of timing, which Latinos do a lot. And let's see what we can do with it. Here we go. Thank you.
y entonces moriré después. Azul que tiene el cielo y el mar. Vive enseña voz para mí, sin ver que estoy aquí, perdido en mi soledad. Sombras bravas acariciando mis manos, sombras nada más que en el temblor de mi voz. Muriendo, en lágrimas viviendo, el pasaje más horrendo, de ser rama sin final. Sombras nada más, entre tu vida y mi vida. Sombras nada más, entre tu amor y mi amor. Qué breve fue tu presencia y así. Que días fueron tus manos, tu voz. Como luciérnaga llegó tu luz y disipó las sombras de mi amor. Y yo quedé como un duende en blanco, sin el azul de tus ojos en mar. Que se han cerrado para mí, sin estoy aquí, perdido en mi soledad. Sombras nada más, acariciando mis manos. Sombras nada más, en el temblor de mi voz. Pude ser feliz, y estoy en vida muriendo. Lágrimas viviendo, el pasaje más horrendo, de ese drama sin final. Sombras nada más, entre tu vida y mi vida. Sombras nada más, entre tu amor y mi We'll be right back.